bestows his sovereignty upon whomever he wills. Allah is embracing and knowing. And their prophet said to them, the proof of his kingship is that the ark will be restored to you, bringing tranquility from your Lord, and relics left by the family of Moses and the family of Aaron. It will be carried by the angels. And that is a sign for you, if you are believers. When Saul set out with the troops, he said, Allah will be testing you with a river. Whoever drinks from it does not belong with me. But whoever does not drink from it, does belong with me, except for whoever scoops up a little with his hand. But they drank from it, except for a few of them. Then, when he crossed it, he and those who believed with him, they said, we have no strength to face Goliath and his troops today. But those who knew that they would meet Allah said, how many a small group has defeated a large group by Allah's will? Allah is with the steadfast. And when they confronted Goliath and his troops, they said, our Lord, pour down patience on us, and strengthen our foothold, and support us against the faithless people. And they defeated them by Allah's leave, and David killed Goliath, and Allah gave him sovereignty and wisdom, and taught him as he willed. Were it not for Allah restraining the people, some by means of others, the earth would have gone to ruin. But Allah is gracious towards mankind. These are Allah's revelations, which we recite to you in truth. You are one of the messengers. These messengers, we gave some advantage over others. To some of them Allah spoke directly, and some he raised in rank. We gave Jesus, son of Mary, the clear miracles, and we strengthened him with the Holy Spirit. Had Allah willed, those who succeeded them would not have fought one another, after the clear signs had come to them, but they disputed. Some of them believed, and some of them disbelieved. Had Allah willed, they would not have fought one another, but Allah does whatever he desires. O you who believe, spend from what we have given you, before a day comes in which there is neither trading, nor friendship, nor intercession. The disbelievers are the wrongdoers. Allah. There is no God except He, the living, the everlasting. Neither slumber overtakes Him, nor sleep. To Him belongs everything in the heavens and everything on earth. Who is He that can intercede with Him except with His permission? He knows what is before them, and what is behind them, and they cannot grasp any of His knowledge, except as He wills. His throne extends over the heavens and the earth, and their preservation does not burden him. He is the Most High, the Great. There shall be no compulsion in religion. The right way has become distinct from the wrong way. Whoever renounces evil and believes in Allah has grasped the most trustworthy handle, which does not break. Allah is hearing and knowing. Allah is the Lord of those who believe. He brings them out of darkness and into light. As for those who disbelieve, their lords are the evil ones, they bring them out of light and into darkness, these are the inmates of the fire, in which they will abide forever. Have you not considered him who argued with Abraham about his Lord, because Allah had given him sovereignty? Abraham said, my Lord is he who gives life and causes death. He said, I give life and cause death. Abraham said, Allah brings the sun from the east, so bring it from the west. So the blasphemer was confounded. Allah does not guide the wrongdoing people. Or like him who passed by a town collapsed on its foundations. He said, how can Allah revive this after its demise? Thereupon Allah caused him to die for 100 years, and then resurrected him. He said, for how long have you tarried? He said, I have tarried for a day, or part of a day. He said, no. You have tarried for 100 years. Now look at your food and your drink, it has not spoiled, and look at your donkey. We will make you a wonder for mankind. And look at the bones, how we arrange them, and then clothe them with flesh. So when it became clear to him, he said, I know that Allah has power over all things. And when Abraham said, my Lord, show me how you give life to the dead. He said, "Have you not believed?" He said, "Yes, but to put my heart at ease." He said, "Take four birds, and incline them to yourself, then place a part on each hill, then call to them, and they will come rushing to you. And know that Allah is powerful and wise." The parable of those who spend their wealth in Allah's way is that of a grain that produces seven spikes, in each spike is 100 grains. Allah multiplies for whom He wills. Allah is bounteous and knowing. Those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah, and then do not follow up what they spent with reminders of their generosity or with insults, will have their reward with their Lord. They have nothing to fear, nor shall they grieve. Kind words and forgiveness are better than charity followed by insults. Allah is rich and clement. O you who believe, do not nullify your charitable deeds with reminders and hurtful words, like him who spends his wealth to be seen by the people, and does not believe in Allah and the Last Day. His likeness is that of a smooth rock covered with soil, a downpour strikes it, and leaves it bare, they gain nothing from their efforts. Allah does not guide the disbelieving people. And the parable of those who spend their wealth seeking Allah's approval, and to strengthen their souls, is that of a garden on a hillside. If heavy rain falls on it, its produce is doubled, and if no heavy rain falls, then dew is enough. Allah is seeing of everything you do. Would any one of you like to have a garden of palms and vines, under which rivers flow, with all kinds of fruit in it for him, and old age has stricken him, and he has weak children, then a tornado with fire batters it, and it burns down? Thus Allah makes clear the signs for you, so that you may reflect. O you who believe, give of the good things you have earned, and from what we have produced for you from the earth. And do not pick the inferior things to give away, when you yourselves would not accept it except with eyes closed. And know that Allah is sufficient and praiseworthy. Satan promises you poverty, and urges you to immorality, but Allah promises you forgiveness from himself, and grace. Allah is embracing and knowing. He gives wisdom to whomever he wills. Whoever is given wisdom has been given much good. But none pays heed except those with insight. Whatever charity you give, or a pledge you fulfill, Allah knows it. The wrongdoers have no helpers. If you give charity openly, that is good. But if you keep it secret, and give it to the needy in private, that is better for you. It will atone for some of your misdeeds. Allah is cognizant of what you do. Their guidance is not your responsibility, but Allah guides whom He wills. Any charity you give is for your own good. Any charity you give shall be for the sake of Allah. Any charity you give will be repaid to you in full, and you will not be wronged. It is for the poor, those who are restrained in the way of Allah, and unable to travel in the land. The unaware would think them rich, due to their dignity. You will recognize them by their features. They do not ask from people insistently. Whatever charity you give, Allah is aware of it. Those who spend their wealth by night and day, privately and publicly, will receive their reward from their Lord. They have nothing to fear, nor shall they grieve. Those who swallow usury will not rise, except as someone driven mad by Satan's touch. That is because they say, "Commerce is like usury." But Allah has permitted commerce, and has forbidden usury. Whoever, on receiving advice from his Lord, refrains, may keep his past earnings, and his case rests with Allah. But whoever assumes, these are the dwellers of the fire, wherein they will abide forever. Allah condemns usury, and he blesses charities. Allah does not love any sinful ingrate. Those who believe, and do good deeds, and pray regularly, and give charity, they will have their reward with their Lord. They will have no fear, nor shall they grieve. O you who believe, fear Allah, and forgo what remains of usury, if you are believers. If you do not, then take notice of a war by Allah and His Messenger. but if you repent, you may keep your capital, neither wronging, nor being wronged. But if he is in hardship, then deferment until a time of ease. But to remit it as charity is better for you, if you only knew. And guard yourselves against today when you will be returned to Allah, then each soul will be rewarded fully for what it has earned, and they will not be wronged. O you who believe, when you incur debt among yourselves for a certain period of time, write it down. And have a scribe write in your presence, in all fairness. And let no scribe refuse to write, as Allah has taught him. So let him write, and let the debtor dictate. And let him fear Allah, his Lord, and diminish nothing from it. But if the debtor is mentally deficient, or weak, or unable to dictate, then let his guardian dictate with honesty. And call to witness two men from among you. If two men are not available, then one man and two women whose testimony is acceptable to all. If one of them fails to remember, the other would remind her. Witnesses must not refuse when called upon. And do not think it too trivial to write down, whether small or large, including the time of repayment. That is more equitable with Allah, and stronger as evidence, and more likely to prevent doubt, except in the case of a spot transaction between you. Then there is no blame on you if you do not write it down. And let there be witnesses whenever you conclude a contract, and let no harm be done to either scribe or witness. If you do that, it is corruption on your part. And fear Allah. Allah teaches you. Allah is aware of everything. If you are on a journey, and cannot find a scribe, then a security deposit should be handed over. But if you trust one another, let the trustee fulfill his trust, and let him fear Allah, his Lord. And do not conceal testimony. Whoever conceals it is sinner at heart. Allah is aware of what you do. To Allah belongs everything in the heavens and the earth. Whether you reveal what is within yourselves, or conceal it, Allah will call you to account for it. He forgives whom he wills, and he punishes whom he wills. Allah is able to do all things. The messenger has believed in what was revealed to him from his Lord, as did the believers. They all have believed in Allah, and his angels, and his scriptures, and his messengers. We make no distinction between any of his messengers. And they say, we hear and we obey. Your forgiveness, our Lord. To you is the destiny. Allah does not burden any soul beyond its capacity. To its credit is what it earns, and against it is what it commits. Our Lord, do not condemn us if we forget or make a mistake. Our Lord, do not burden us as you have burdened those before us. Our Lord, do not burden us with more than we have strength to bear, and pardon us, and forgive us, and have mercy on us. You are our Lord and Master, so help us against the disbelieving people.